So how do you define if Macs are secure? There is a security game you can play, and it's kind of like the EU-CPA game, but now instead of trying to read the message and break confidentiality, you are now going to try and tamper with the message and break integrity. So first, let me tell you what it is in text, and then we'll think about the game, just like we did for EU-CPA. So the property that you want is that if the attacker doesn't know the key, they should not be able to generate valid tags. That would be really bad if you didn't know the key, but you could generate valid tags, because then the attacker, without the key, can pick their own malicious message, generate a valid tag that Bob thinks is correct, and we can feed that to Bob, and now he thinks that the malicious message is correct. So we should never have a case where attackers who don't know K can generate Macs on messages of their choosing. That should not be allowed. Another equivalent way of stating that is that if I give you a Mac, you should not be able to tamper the message and then also tamper the Mac to match the message. That's kind of like the tampering attack we saw from earlier with hashes. We don't want that to be possible if you don't know the key. So if someone gives you a message and a tag, you should not be able to modify the message and then modify the tag so that they check out. Any modification you do should break the Mac. That's what it means to be unforgeable. Mallory should not be able to forge or make a fake tag that checks out. And again, we're going to define this using a security game where if Mallory wins, the scheme is not secure, and if Alice wins, it is secure. So here's the game. It's a bit shorter than the EU-CPA game. So the first thing we'll do is kind of like the EU-CPA game, we will create a query phase. This is the phase where Mallory gets to exercise her powers, and this is where the CPA comes from, chosen plaintext attack. That's the threat model we talked about. So this is where Mallory gets to exercise her powers from the threat model. She gets to play this as many times as she wants, formerly a polynomial number of times. She can't do this forever, but she can repeat this as many times as she feels like. And what she'll do is she'll tell Alice, here's a message. Can you generate a Mac for me? And Alice will faithfully take the key and the message that Mallory provided, generate the Mac, and send it back to Mallory. So in other words, Mallory gets to see Macs for messages that she chooses. And she can do this for as many times as she wants, formerly a polynomial number of times. You can't do this forever. But this is Mallory doing the chosen plaintext attack. It's kind of like how Mallory got to trick Alice into encrypting messages, but now she is tricking Alice into creating Macs on messages. Mallory doesn't know the key, but she can trick Alice into using the key to generate Macs on any message she likes. And you can imagine, Mallory might try to use this section to maybe learn something about the Mac scheme, find some flaws in it, or maybe try and learn what the key is. Maybe the scheme leaks a key. So if the scheme is insecure, it's possible that Mallory uses this section to learn something about it that breaks the scheme. That would be Mallory's goal as she does this first query phase. So eventually Mallory gets bored of this scheme, or she thinks she found a trick to solve this scheme or to break it, and she says, I'm ready for my challenge. So we're done with this phase in blue. We're done with tricking Alice into sending us Macs. Mallory's ready for the challenge. And the challenge is just this. Give me a message and a tag that match. That's it. So if you can find a message and a tag such that the Mac of the message M prime with a secret key matches the tag that Mallory chooses, she wins. This is her forging a tag that she was not supposed to be able to forge because she doesn't know the key. Now, one important caveat here is that you can't use one of the original messages. That's cheating. So if you've already seen a message and the Mac on the message, you cannot pick that message again here in the challenge phase. The scheme is deterministic, so doing that would allow Mallory to win every single time, and that's not a very useful game. So Mallory has to choose a new message that she hasn't seen before. She has to come up with a tag on it. That's any sequence of ones and zeros that she chooses. And if it is the case that you take this message, you compute the Mac with the key, and you get the tag that Mallory provided, then she wins. She was able to forge a tag that she wasn't supposed to. And if this is not possible, whatever message tag pair she chooses, she cannot get them to check out, then we say that Mallory loses. And the scheme is EU-CPA secure if Mallory is losing no matter what strategy she chooses. No matter what she tries to do, she can never come up with something that checks out. That's how we say she loses.